Like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports.
Damier Bird returning it.
The lane opens here. He's past the 30. Damier Bird. And able to break this out all the way to the 38-yard line. Great return.
At their own 38-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll run with a former Super Bowl hero. It's James White. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down.
Well, at the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back down and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of 1? A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is 3rd and 7. Now it's Newton. The ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked by the rookie, Michael O.J. Mutia. And he's able to take this one back to the 36-yard line. Well, it's no secret, he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions, can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. It's 1st and 10 from the 12. Now the former fourth-round pick, it's Kalen Ballage. And the Broncos are going to be set up with a 1st and goal. He couldn't quite reach the chalk, but they'll have it at the 1-yard line. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a 1st down. Here's a run with Ballage, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score.
Touchdown.
Kalen Ballage, his 4th touchdown on the year, and the Broncos have taken the early lead. And he's got it, 7-0 Broncos.
Makes the score, Broncos 7, Patriots nothing.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start 1st and 10. They'll start the drive with a give to White. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
On 2nd down now, it's White. He gets them a little over half of what they needed. Now they're looking at a 3rd and 5.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
To throw is Newton. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Looks like a 2nd empty possession to start the game, and certainly not the way you want to start when you come in off of a loss last week. Every team talks about starting fast. They're hoping on their next possession it can be a delayed fast start and get them going.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline.
K.J. Hamler on the return. The Broncos take over first and
the Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. He'll let this go deep for Sutton. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Cortland Sutton, first-time Pro Bowler. He was the intended target. On first and 10, here's Locke. He's got his big tight end, Fant. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll bring up a second down.
8 yards on the pickup, brings up second and 2. At the Patriots, 27-yard.
They fake the handoff, now Locke. This is the tight end, Fant. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Noah Fant was a first-round pick in 2019, and he was picked because of his receiving skills. Had 40 catches in his rookie season for 562 yards. Did have 2 games where he topped 100 yards in each of those. Yes, he's still developing as a blocker, but that's not why he went in the first round. He went there for his ability to make big plays down the field.
Denver Broncos are in for 6.
To Jerry Jeudy. Touchdown.
A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And the results for them have not been strong to this point. 2 drives have ended in a turnover and then a punt.
So would it be too snarky for me to say that they've shown improvement? Because you had two drives with turnovers. Now they punted it away, so at least they didn't turn it over. That's good, right?
You're going to get some angry users reaching out to you on social media.
Well, I don't mean to be. I was actually looking for the positive. Silver lining, you know.
So now a fresh set of downs. First and 10 after roughing the passer. The drive starts with a completion. Left side. 3 yards the gain there, second down. A lot of storylines to a New England-Denver matchup. So many great games in the past. And worth noting, too, that Cam, of course, has his history with the Broncos as well. He was on the losing end of Super Bowl 50 when his Panthers lost to the Broncos 24-10. And he'll hit his tight end, Walker. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Newton on third down. On the left side, a catch by White. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46.
A loss of 2 yards.
It'll wind up being a loss of 2. And that'll bring up fourth down.
Formation for the Patriots.
And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline. And they won't risk defending a return here. That one's out of bounds, and it'll be spotted at the 14-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They've got things going their way early. 14-0 lead and the football. First and 10. He'll go up top here for Hamlin. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10.
Second and 10.
Throwing again. Locke. Open man Hamler. That's complete. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this this situation, the defense was effective.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And down inside the red zone at the 19-yard line.
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
That went good for 17 yards, and now they've got it first and goal. They'll run for it. This is White. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage back to the 4-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. A loss
of two. I know defensive coordinator is going to be pretty excited by what he just saw there. Great knockback by their front. And now with the ball where it is, I would expect to see the offense throw the ball on second and third down here.
And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage, back at the 6. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up. Newton. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
The offense stays out there. A big challenge here from this far back, but they're going for it on fourth and goal. Touchdown nor the first down, and it'll be a turnover on downs. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. In his end zone, here's Locke. And that's complete. Albert Okwuegbunam. And he's able to get this one up to the 8-yard line this time. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
And it's third down.
From the gun, it's Locke. Got a man complete. It's Hamler. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. First carry for Royce Freeman. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play. Check 50, check 50.
From the gun, it's a run for Freeman. Call it a gain of 12, but of course not a first down due to the previous penalty. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
14, Patriots nothing.
Balaj. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And up
to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. A gain of 13, it's a first down.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed, and he's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. They look to throw. It's locked. That's going to be caught by Judy. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Patriots 36.
A gain of 27.
A very solid gain of 27.
First down.
Throwing on first down is Locke. Flushed out right. Now he'll pull it down. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down. 2 minutes gone by, second quarter.
First down, Broncos.
Into the red zone, it's Locke. Left side here, that's the tight end Fant. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score.
Noah Fant.
Noah Fant, his first touchdown of the year. And the Broncos will extend their lead. And it is now 21 to nothing.
Makes the score, Broncos 21. Patriots nothing.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Pats at the line, ready to go. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go-around? He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Bryce Callahan. And it's a tremendous return as they finally get him at about the 10-yard line.
By the Broncos.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where's he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
A gain of a yard. Brings up second and nine at the Patriots' 9-yard line.
Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down.
He was brought down.
Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on third and eight. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown.
Touchdown.
Kalen Ballage with his second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Broncos push further out in front. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. Meeting the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Andrew Beck, his first touchdown on the year. And the Broncos will add on to their lead. Set him back 5 yards. They'll try it again now after the 5-yard walk-off. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now.
Makes the score Broncos 28, Patriots nothing.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Cam going to bring the Patriots up now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They begin the drive on the ground. It's White, and he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
From the 27, Newton steps away to his left, and now he's going to use his legs. So an instance there of Cam being Cam. We know he can use his legs.
And with that big body, it's hard to get him down, even if you get a clear shot on him. Plus, he moves it a lot faster than what people think. And boy, does he have fun playing the game of football.
He'll be brought down by the Broncos. It's a sack. Jarrell Casey bursting in to take him down.
Jarrell Casey plays this game with passion and aggression, as well as great intelligence, and he's been awfully consistent as well. At least 5 sacks each year since 2013, 9 seasons previously in Tennessee.
Cam fighting, he lost the football, it's out. It's picked up by the Broncos, and they are gonna set up shop at the 40-yard line.
You think about it, Charles, this is not a quarterback that's used to running the football a lot, and that time he was loose with it, had it knocked free.
He always has to think to himself that there's always going to be traffic around because of what you just said. Not that elusive, not going to get to...
And the pass is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Jerry Jeudy.
Brandon McManus.
Jerry Jeudy with his second touchdown of the game and 5th on the year. And the Broncos continue to pour it on. And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call.
Brandon McManus to kick off.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Newton and the Patriots with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. The drive starts with a run by White. Now White lost the football. It's picked up by the Broncos. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives, fumbles on their last two, I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down with it? And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown.
Jerry Jeudy
on his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And the Broncos add on. And the route is on here in this first half.
Makes the score Broncos 42. Patriots nothing. Brandon McManus.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
First and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
You know, they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. 23 yards the pick up there.
At the 43-yard line.
First down, here's White. And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. Tackled by Bradley Chubb, the number 5 pick in the 2018 draft. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. A shotgun snap for Newton. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos 30. 23 yards the pickup there. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10.
Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, and one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
From the 27, Newton. That's complete into the hands of Myers.
Newton's pass.
A one-yard gain there following the three-yard pickup on first down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Going for it all. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on, a big call coming on third down. So the pass incomplete in the end zone, but contact and pass interference.
And now where does the ball get placed?
At the one-yard line.
One-yard line. They gave up excellent real estate on that one. That's going to work really, really well.
And he is in. Touchdown, New England. It's the fullback. His first touchdown on the year. And the Pats able to eat in just a bit to this sizable deficit. Nick Folk for the point after. Oh, and now they're going to fake it. And he's got it in the end zone. Bit of a surprising call here, down by as many as they are, but the fake works, and they'll get 2 points closer instead of one. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just give them a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is, they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
And now they're just looking to add to that total. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 15 yards on the play, first down.
I know a lot of Denver fans are really excited about the possibilities for Cortland Sutton now that Drew Locke is entrenched as their starting quarterback. Remember, last season, the last 5 games with Locke as the guy in charge.
And that's caught inside the 30. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 36 yards on the play. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Now Locke again. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Kalen Ballage out of the backfield. That'll bring up second down.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. Now Ballage. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8. An extra corner comes on now for the Patriots D on third down. Locke working out of the gun. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
Complete on the throwaway. It's now fourth down.
So on fourth down, on comes Brandon McManus and the field goal unit for the Broncos.
37-yard attempt.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And oh,
the gamble fails. It's incomplete. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. And the Patriots defense is going to take over on downs.
They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. Here's a second and five now from the 25. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, I guess the last score wasn't enough for them. They want more. Here comes an onside kick. And the Broncos are going to get the football. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. And going for Hamler, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Dante Hightower. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Second and 10.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat.
And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. The sack there by Bradley Chubb.
So now after the sack, Cam of the Patriots going to look up at a third and long.
From the gun, here's Newton. He's got the hookup to Lee. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. That good for 19 yards as they pick up the conversion on third. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Out of the gun, Newton. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Draymond Jones. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of six. Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Another try after the first down sack. Newton throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Marquise Lee, the intended target. And that'll make it third down.
He's had trouble finding open receivers all game, CD, and that's because really there hasn't been many. This defense has been all over them.
Yeah, they're one of the better defenses in the league, and every time I talk to someone around the NFL, they all say the exact same thing. They're so fundamentally sound, it's hard to execute against them.
Ball had his hands on it, couldn't bring it in. Pretty symptomatic of how this game's been going. Here's Nick Folk now on for the field goal. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt.
42.
Kind of surprised by that they kicked the field goal. I guess you get some points, but this deficit third quarter, I don't know.
Yeah, I don't either. And I'm with you on that one. When you're down that much, kicking a field goal, does it feel a little bit maybe waving the white flag and just want to get out of here? Yeah, I think you got to go ahead and try and get some bigger points on the board.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. This one into the hands of the running back, Ballage. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
Brings up second and 7 at the 28-yard line.
Shotgun snap to Locke. And it's a fumble. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
There are two words that we hear coaches say all of the time. One starts with a B, one starts with an S. Ball security.
And they preach it. They have it up in the meeting rooms, right? You see the signs. They talk about it all the time. But still, when you've got defenders out there who are preaching, hey, we're going to take the ball away from you, no matter what position you play, you've got to take care of the rock.
Second and 9.
Second and 9 at the 29-yard line.
From the gun, Newton. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down. They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down. Operating from the gun, Newton. And he'll have his man, that's Edelman. And he will have a Patriots first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Edelman's first catch, and it's good for a first down.
At the 17-yard line.
Here's White. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
They keep it on the ground. White again. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. So a decent deficit at this stage in the second half. 4-down territory?
No doubt about it. There's not a chance that he hasn't looked ahead and said, okay, if we gain yardage on this play, this is what we'll do going forward. If we lose yardage, this is the play call.
And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
Second and goal.
Two of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. They'll let the fullback try and take him home. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. A gain of 2 there on the heels of a 1-yard pickup on first.
And goal.
They'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. And they will run it with Michelle. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. Boy, that's a 5-yard loss. Fourth down now.
The short field shrinks even more with the type of bodies they brought in on that play. Those extra tight ends, they weren't able to secure their blocks, and that one ended up going backwards.
And the 12-year veteran knocks it right through. And now they'll just need 4 touchdowns as the deficit is now 28. That drive took them inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold them to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
The Broncos take over first and 10. Their own 21-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
Coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think Coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield and punch in the end zone without turning it over.
Locke will try again on second down. That's caught over the middle by Fant. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Noah Fant, 79 yards. And this offense continues to pour it on.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Frustration after the PAT miss. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, and he opted for the touchback. Big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who could make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes good plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
11 yards there, first down.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I wonder if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long. But nice throw there for a good game and a first down.
He's going to let this go deep for Lee. And this one is incomplete.
But you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those. But the coverage has been excellent thus far. And it was again on the last play.
Back to the air. Newton on second down. And the Broncos get there and take him down. Michael O.J. Mutia in there to drop him, and that will go in the books as the first sack of his young NFL career. Congratulations, young man. Third and long, it's Newton. He sets to fire deep. That's a room to maneuver. And a terrific return as he takes this thing all the way down to the 20-yard line.
This has been one mistake after another on the offensive side of the ball. That's now three interceptions to go along with two fumbles for him. And if you're going to turn the ball over five times in a game, your chances to win have to be about 100-1. And it's not looking good for him here.
Flush to his right. And he's going to keep it here. He's got the first down inside the 10. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain. Lock going to keep this himself. And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Drew Lock scoring on the keeper from 6 yards out. And the Broncos use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6.
Brandon McManus.
Now McManus to tack on the extra point. PAT would extend their lead, but there is a flag on the play. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Their own 25-yard line.
Cam going to bring the Patriots up now, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They start the drive with White. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. Second and 6, just inside the 30.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and 6.
From the gun, Newton. And they get to Newton and take him down for the sack.
Brandon, I think you understand. understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
Back now in Foxborough. Patriots. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. New England on third down. Not so hot. 2 for 9 to this point. This will be third and forever. This is White on the screen. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Here's Newton. And this is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Broncos are going to get the football back in great field position. Historically, this is such a tough, loud venue, but you can hear a pin drop right now. A lot of fans long gone, not used to seeing a lopsided score like this. Give them 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Pickup of 3 brings up 2nd and 7.
Freeman again. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Give him 3 on the run there. Now they're looking at a 3rd and about 5.
And it's 3rd down.
Operating from the gun. Lock. And Lock throws another one. It's intercepted. Picked up by Jonathan Jones. And he'll go down inside the 15 at his own 13-yard line. And they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right? The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. Started as they come up on a 1st and 10. Going on the ground, it's White. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, 1st down. Defensively, you've got the nice lead here in the fourth quarter. You're saying, if they want to get a run of a little over 10 yards, that's okay.
I hear what you're doing there, and I think you're onto something. They've loosened up on defense, so don't get fooled by the nice runs you're getting now. You've got to get bigger plays, possibly think about throwing the football a bit more here.
James White.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Brings up 2nd and 11 at the 29-yard line.
2nd and 11. Now Newton. Oh, it's a screen pass. It's complete. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. That'll wind up as a loss on the play. So now they're staring at a 3rd down and 12.
Let's go defense. Let's go defense.
Here's Newton. And that one complete to Keene, the tight end. And he's going to be taken down here, still a couple yards short of the first. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for 4th down.
A short game that doesn't get them the 1st down brings up a 4th down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it.
Thank you.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. And nowhere to go. He's going to be stopped behind the line. He needed a couple, but he didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. And the Broncos are going to get the football back in great field position. So from the 36 now, first and 10. And some space here. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. That time he was looking for Jerry Jeudy. So that one just a little touch pass, but it paid off quite handsomely.
Yeah, and let's face it, the quarterback loves it because it pads his stats as a completed pass for nice yardage downfield. But I like the way they get the receiver in motion. It's almost like he's running a route before he gets the football, because he's got a full head of steam when the ball is popped in his direction.
And Brandon, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Seem in a rush. I guess they just didn't know where the play clock was.
I think you're right about that, because there was no hurried movements there, right? No up-tempo at all. Clock just ran out. I think he was as surprised as maybe his bench was.
Hey, check. Mike 21.
Stepping, hammering for the goal line. He loses the football, and it's picked up by the Patriots. And they'll have the football, but deep in their own territory as he's brought down at the 5. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
And they'll get him down up past the 15-yard line. That'll go for a gain of 13, helping big time to get away from that end zone. First down. Going with White here, toss left. White's got a first down and more. And all the way up to the 33-yard line. Give him 15 yards on that one, and New England has a first down. Now a carry for White. Not much there. Maybe a couple up to the 35.
The ball carrier.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
At the 35-yard line.
Watch twist. Watch eight. Switch gears. Switch gears. Check.
They'll run with White. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
The tackle made at the 36.
But now they're in a spot that every team tells us when we have our production meetings they don't want to be in, third and long. And that's because those back-to-back running plays just didn't accomplish a whole lot.
Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair.
We'll take that. We'll take that.
So the Patriots with the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And very little room to maneuver. He'll get this down to about the 39. Give him 3 yards there, as that'll take us to fourth down. And it appears the offense is going to try this again. They've yet to convert the first 3 times on fourth down, but they're going once more. And he'll be corralled out across midfield down to the 45. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Now a first down throw for Newton. On the left side, a catch by White.
Newton's
And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. They'll come up on a second and four now from the 40-yard line. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's White. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And this one has gone pretty well to form. They've come in, had little problem thus far, and now they'll try to polish. And that's caught inside the 35. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, business as usual for them. Well on their way to another victory. Riding a serious wave of momentum from what we've seen. And so far, they haven't met their match. So if you're going to play this team in the future, your mission is clear. You better be ready to play and match their firepower.
McManus now for the extra point. Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
Broncos 62, Patriots 14.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away.
The Patriots take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Throw left side, complete. It's White. And he'll be out right at the 35. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
At the 35-yard line.
From the gun, Newton. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. A gain of just a yard, but it's a first down. And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left. So from the 36 now, first and 10. To throw is Newton. He's going to let it fly. And now here is another interception. Picked off at about the 31. And he will be out of bounds here with zeros on the clock as this ball game is over. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Broncos, their strong September has carried over to October as they move to 5-0. And they'll return home next week to take on the Miami Dolphins. Meanwhile, for the Patriots, they'll fall to 1-4 with a loss. And perhaps